Well, also apparently backstage of the show were signs no more leg slapping.
Yeah, they
are you kidding me?
I'm not kidding you. I will read it because I actually have the sign in front of me. Do not slap leg when kicking is the sign. It was in the gorilla position, outside the gorilla position, and it wasn't the only sign. There was like a couple of signs around backstage, so you couldn't miss it. Do not slap leg when kicking. That's the new doctrine. I don't know. This is what I was told, okay? But this is not like official. Like, I'm going to get an official thing. Anyway, what I was told was that at some point on a SmackDown show, somebody did a leg slapping deal and Vince got mad because it was so obvious. Now, it couldn't have been that obvious, because if it was that obvious, me and you would have probably gotten really mad.
Well, not only that, but there's a lot of obvious shit that we see that Vince doesn't seem to care at all about. But he sees one leg slap and now they're banned?
Well, I think it's more than one, but yeah, it's but you know, it's like you know, I mean, have you noticed that ever since this subject came up about how all the old timers are on there, and oh yeah, you know, and it's like, what the I mean,
dude,
it's like,
you know why people my age slap their leg? Because of Shawn Michaels, who was slapping his leg in the 90s.
But Chris Adams was doing the 80s.
Sure, and I'm sure people a little bit younger than me saw Tajiri slapping his leg when they were watching the Attitude Era.
Everyone was doing it for decades.
I mean, come on. There's been leg slapping for 1,000 years. You know, the other thing is, when you slap your leg, I used to do a super kick all the time. Not one time did I ever consciously slap my leg. It's because I slapped my leg for so many years that you don't even think about it. You go for the move and it just happens.
Well, that's
so
what
the
Nikki
idea
Bella
that
did.
There's going to
the
be a sign and like all of a sudden everyone's going to not slap their leg. I mean, dude, there's going to be leg slapping all over the place. There just will. People can't help themselves.
Jey Uso did it on the show, on that very show,
because you
with
can't
all those
help
signs.
Yourself.
I know, because
you don't even think about it. It's an automatic thing that happens when you do this.
I know. So the whole thing is like, the thing to me that is so crazy about this has been going on since I've been watching wrestling, and that's almost 50 years. And it was considered the sign of a good worker to have your timing down and make it look like it, you know what I mean? And now, because some old timers, and maybe young timers or whatever, some fans or who knows what, complained about that they're doing it too much. He just wants to get rid of it for whatever reason. You know what you can say? Like I said this to Garrett last night. It's like, I can, if you go in there and you go, you know what, they're doing too many of these on a show. Okay. And I can accept that. You know, I mean, there's different philosophies of how you put together a show. You know, some show philosophies are one way, and there's no right or wrong. I mean, there's a right or wrong in the sense of, if you do a whole bunch, and if the main eventers do it and it doesn't get over, or you've done so many in a match where they're not as over as they were at the start of the match, you've done too many, okay? But that's a separate issue, okay? So if you feel that there's too much of it, you could absolutely have the agents go, look, Jey Uso's in the main event on SmackDown tonight. He's gonna do some super kicks because that's what he does. And Daniel Bryan might do him because he sometimes does it too. Okay? So the rest of you guys, no kicks. Okay? No kicks of that nature. You know, you can do all the other stuff. We're gonna save it for the main event. And if that is your philosophy on wrestling, that's fine. But to like make this rule that's, you know, that of course they're gonna probably forget in 2 months, but even like to be bothered by it, it's just so you know, with all the problems that they have, that's
dude, this is at the bottom of the list of problems they have,
and it's not even a problem, because
it's not
like,
even leg slaps either. It's like, this has been from the beginning of wrestling. People used to do the knee lift and slap the guy on the back, or Flair puts a guy in the headlock and he does a short punch and whacks his own ribs to make the sound effect. This shit's been going on forever.
The Bobby Eaton stuff, yeah. No, I mean, got into an argument with somebody about that and actually brought up Mr. Wrestling 2 in the knee lift, and we would hit the guy. And he would hit, you know, it's like, he would hit the other guy, you know, when he did the knee lift, he would hit the other guy in the back really hard so it'd make a lot of noise because the knee's supposed to like crack you in the face. And the knee, as a general rule, never cracked you in the face, which is a good thing. So he would hit the guy in the back really hard. Okay. So it's like, that's like the 70s, like 45 years ago.
Dude, not even that. How about, you ever had one of your buddies decide they were going to stomp a mud hole in a friend of yours? What do they all do?
No.
They stomp, because people have been doing a stomp when they throw a kick for about 100 years.
Stomp,
which is the exact same thing, whatever. It's exact. You hit the guy's head in the buckle and he stomps the mat as he hits his head on the buckle.
Yep.
This shit's been going on for, it's all a sound effect. People just, I guess they're upset about super kicks because so many super kicks are thrown nowadays. But the idea that like, this is one horrible thing that kids today just started doing, that's a load of shit.
I know. Well, I mean, the funny thing is, remember when Orton and Ciampa got in that big argument over the thigh slapping? And it's like freaking Randy.
And then the very next week, Randy does the loudest thigh slap of all time for a punt. Like a week later.
But Randy Orton thigh slapped every freaking punt that he ever did. So it's like it's this weird thing of like the veterans who all did it saying that it's bad because they're trying to run down the young guys for doing it. It's just the weirdest. It's so weird. It's so, you know, whatever. So anyway, that's like the latest controversy in WWE. I mean, if anything, they should be concentrating on their booking making sense and not worried about stuff that, like, you know, a tiny percentage of the audience is mad about, and they don't even, because the percentage of the audience that's mad about it actually doesn't know all these things that you and I just said, and they think that it was like something that like the Young Bucks came up with, and the Young Bucks don't know how to work and they're terrible, so therefore, and these WWE guys are like copying them, and it's like the Young Bucks freaking copied Shawn Michaels, who copied Chris Adams, and God knows where Chris Adams was the one who as far as the super kick goes, but I mean, as far as the sound effect stuff, God even knows where that came from. I'm going to guess that probably dates back to the 30s. Maybe even earlier than that. Who knows?
Hey, if you're a big fan of Wrestling Observer Radio, we got 12,000 episodes of all of our podcasts up at our website, WrestlingObserver.com. If you sign up today, you get access to every single one of them. The 12 to 18 new shows that we do every single week. You can podcast them, listen to them on the road, at work, working out, in the shower, wherever you listen to your podcasts, and also full access to the Wrestling Observer newsletter and archives. So if you love what you hear, head to WrestlingObserver.com. 12,000 audio shows at your fingertips.